upon knowledge and upon evidence. This is what we learn, brothers and sisters. And to further bolster your understanding of what I've said, consider how Islam has made the tool of Islam, which tool? The pen. The pen, is that not a tool, an instrument of education? It is. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the tool and instrument of Islam, the pen. Allah said, الَّذِي عَلَّمَ بِالْقَلَمِ, the one who taught by the pen. Allah says, Noon, وَالْقَلَمِ وَمَا يَسْطُرُونَ. Allah takes a qasam by the pens, by the pen, and what they inscribe and transcribe. Allahu Akbar. The pen is the tool of Islam. And the pen is a tool of education, an instrument of education. And consider further, my dear brothers and sisters, here in front of me and those at home, the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the mercy of Him teaching us the Quran before the mercy of Him creating you and I. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ar-Rahman. This is one of the beautiful names of Allah. The most merciful, right? Ar-Rahman, the perpetually merciful. What does Allah say? Allama al-Quran. Allah now starts throughout the whole of Surah Ar-Rahman, Allah mentions His mercies upon us. For those who didn't realize, everything after Ar-Rahman, Allah is mentioning His mercies upon us. Everything. Read Surah Ar-Rahman today and glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is the first mercy Allah teaches us? عَلَّمَ Quran. He taught you the Quran. Before خَلَقَ الْإِنسَانِ, it's a mercy that Allah created us. But before the mercy of Allah creating us, Allah mentions the mercy of Allah teaching us the Quran. Allahu Akbar. Religion of knowledge. Religion based upon the concept of education, of reading, of writing. And then after Allah says خَلَقَ الْإِنسَانِ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala further consolidates the point by saying عَلَّمَهُ الْبَيَانِ. Another concept of education, that Allah taught you speech. Education on one end, education on the other end. In the middle, the fact that Allah created us. Subhana Rabbi al-A'la. Subhana Rabbi al-A'la. This is the first lesson we learn, my dear brothers and sisters, when we look at Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam becoming a prophet, and at the same time, the beginning of revelation. Because Jibreel came, he didn't say, Assalamu alaikum. This is who I am. How are you feeling today? He came and said, Iqra. The time for being serious has come. And it starts by being educated, right? Now yesterday, as I said, we discussed this point that the right of Islam is to learn. And for us, brothers and sisters, to understand how important learning is in Islam, if we're not convinced yet, then let's look at what package Islam has placed for the one who learns. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Let's look at the package that Islam has placed for the one who learns. You and I, in the dunya, we always look at the package. When we want to know how good something is, what do? We look at the package. What's on offer? What's the job package here? Tell me, what's the JD, the job description? Tell me, what do I get? Right? I'm a doctor. It's a noble job. Why? Look what they get paid. Look at the perks. Look at the respect. You look at the package that comes with it. Right? CEO of a company. You look at the package that comes with it. Not so? We say it's noble to be a CEO. It's an honor. Why? Because look at the life of it. Look at the package that comes with it. What package has Islam placed with regards to seeking knowledge? What has Islam placed as a package? Before that, understand, brothers and sisters, our scholars rahmatullahi alayhim say that the first command was that you and I learn about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is another evidence which teaches us why seeking knowledge is from the prime core matters of this religion. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ فَعْلَمْ فَعْلَمْ is from the three letter root علم عين لام ميم, which denotes knowledge. فَعْلَمْ and know and learn and be educated about what? لا إله إلا الله, that there's no one worthy of worship besides one Allah. This is the first command. And Ibn al-Qayyim rahmatullahi alayhi has an amazing mention about this ayah. This is a footnote for you all, right? He says rahmatullahi alayhi that subhanallah, this was the first command to learn about Allah, because when the slave learned about Allah, he naturally worshipped Allah. Because you learned who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was. And that's why many a time my brothers and sisters ask me, how do we increase the khushu' in our ibadah? How do we worship Allah better? How do we improve the quality of our salah? How do we improve our intention and our iman? I say to you, my dear brothers and sisters, learn about Allah. Learn about Allah. Learn about Allah using His beautiful names and attributes. Go and learn about Allah. Like I told you earlier, you learn something new about your spouse, what happened to you naturally? You loved her more. Wallahi, the more you learn about Allah, you love Allah more. Your awe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grows. The way you exalt Him grows. The way you praise Him naturally grows. Learn about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. In terms of the package, consider the fact that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, in terms of the merits, the package that comes to the person, the gift, the prize for the one who seeks knowledge, مَنْ سَلَكَ طَرِيقًا يَلْتَمِسُ فِيهِ عِلْمًا سَهَّلَ اللَّهُ لَهُ بِهِ طَرِيقًا إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ. That the one who treads a path seeking Islamic knowledge, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ease his path to Jannah. Allahu Akbar. Whoever treads a path seeking not any knowledge, Islamic knowledge, سَهَّلَ اللَّهُ لَهُ بِهِ طَرِيقًا إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ. Allah will make his path to Jannah easier. Allahu Akbar. Right? We're talking about the package, right? Which makes us understand how noble seeking knowledge is. Look at the prize. What other prizes do we have? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about the alim, wa innal alim la yastaghfir lahu man fis samawat wa man fil ard wal hitan fi jawfil ma. Allahu Akbar. He says sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that indeed the knowledgeable person, everything seeks forgiveness for him. Allah makes everything seek forgiveness for him. Everything on the face of this earth, everything in the skies, and even the fish in the oceans, they seek forgiveness for the scholar. What price would you put on that, my dear brothers and sisters? What price? Priceless. Priceless. Creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you don't know is seeking forgiveness on your behalf? Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Tayyib. What else did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say? He said, خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. The best of you are those who learn the Qur'an and teach it. The best of you. We want to be the best of the best. The best of you is the one who learns, educates themselves, learns the Qur'an and teaches it. They further expand education. What else? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, شَهِدَ اللَّهُ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ وَأُولُو الْعِلْمِ قَائِمًا بِالْقِسْطِ. Allahu Akbar. Allah says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bears testimony that there is no one worthy of worship besides one Allah, and the angels and the people of knowledge are true to this testimony and are upright with regards to this fact that there is no one worthy of worship besides one Allah. The angels and the people of knowledge, Allah mentions them in the same sentence. The angels, you get mentioned with the angels. What else has Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said? Teaching us about the importance of seeking knowledge. يَرْفَعُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ دَرَجَاتِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise those who have believed and those who are the people of knowledge by degrees. Raise them. They're in a league of their own. And how can they not be, brothers and sisters? They have with them the inheritance of the best person to have walked the face of this earth. Imagine if you had with you the most priceless treasure that this world had. How special would you be? Would you be like everybody else? No, you're not. You're a degree above. Why? Because you have something everybody else wants, but they don't have. Right? Imagine you have the inheritance of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wallahi, the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, they understood what seeking knowledge was. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu walks into the markets of Medina and says, what is wrong with you people? The inheritance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is being distributed and you are here? So everybody stopped what they did, what they were doing. Ran. Where, Abu Hurairah? In Masjid al-Nabawi. They run to the masjid. They walk in and they see Quran lessons. And they see hadith lessons and so on and so forth. Meaning lessons of the knowledge which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left behind. They said, where is it being distributed? He says, can you not understand? These circles of knowledge here. In these circles of knowledge, this is where the distribution of the wealth of the Anbiya alayhi salatu wa sallam is. The prophets of Allah, the messengers of Allah, لَمْ يُوَرِّثُوا دِينَارًا وَلَا دِرْهَمًا وَرَّثُوا الْعِلْمَ. They never left behind gold and silver coins. They left behind something more precious. They left behind knowledge, revelation. And knowledge will always be better than wealth. Think about it. Think about it. Money, you have to protect. But knowledge protects you. Wealth, when you spend it, it decreases. Unless you spend it for the sake of Allah. But knowledge, when you spend it, it increases. Have I not spent knowledge now? Telling you? How has it increased? You will take it to hundreds of other people. Knowledge will always be better than wealth. So they left us something even more substantial. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, he says, تَذَاكُرُ الْعِلْمِ بعض الليالي أحب إلي من إحيائها. الله أكبر. Ibn Abbas, he says, growing my knowledge and increasing my knowledge and learning knowledge is more during some of the nights is more beloved to me than spending it alive in salah and so on and so forth. Because the more you learn, the better that salah is going to become. This is the package, brothers and sisters, for the one who learns knowledge. And I'm not saying learn for the sake of it. I'm saying learn for the love of it. Because you love what you learn. Not because of entertainment. Alhamdulillah, today we live in an age where there's a revival. There's a revival. Look at YouTube. Full. MashaAllah. In fact, I hear the youth saying, the YouTube sheikhs. I said, wow man, there's a list called the YouTube sheikhs. Right? MashaAllah, the ilm is there. Everything's being recorded. Look at this, it's being recorded. It's being broadcast to the sisters. It's live streaming online, MashaAllah. And inshallah, it's being recorded. The recordings will be on YouTube. There will be DVDs and MP3s, right? There's a revival. Knowledge is available. The internet, قَدْ قَرَّبَ الْبَعِيدَ, as the scholars say. It's made something which was so far away, so close. Right? There's a revival. But how many people are learning? And that's why I'm citing this point. Don't learn for the sake of it. Don't learn for the entertainment of it. Learn for the love of it. Learn for the sake of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is important. Alhamdulillah, there's a revival with the turn of the century. But sadly, there's another strange phenomenon that needs to be dealt with. And that is this concept of fans. Fans. The lecturer has fans. The sheikh or the student of knowledge, he has fans. People listen to him because of him, not because of what he says. This is not learning for the sake of ilm. This is not learning, and you should learn for the sake of Allah. You shouldn't even, my teachers used to tell me, hafithahumullah, don't even learn to increase your knowledge. Learn for the sake of Allah. And a result of it will be that your knowledge will be increased. Allahu Akbar. I know what they were meaning. They're not saying you should not learn for the sake of knowledge, but they're trying to make your intention even more pure for the sake of Allah. Seeking knowledge is worship. Do it for Allah. The net result is knowledge will increase. It's like you have a business. What's the net result of having a business if you run it properly? You'll have money. You'll get a profit. It's a result of doing something, right? Today, we're learning for entertainment. It doesn't matter what the topic is. What matters is the name of the person coming to speak. This is dangerous, brothers and sisters. This is dangerous. You see, mashallah, over there, the fiqh of food and clothing. You see that? Can you see that? The topic is bigger than the name of the sheikh coming to teach it. That's good. Alhamdulillah. Because your heart should be attached to the topic. That subhanallah, I have an opportunity to learn from the inheritance of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Learning what he taught us with regards to food and clothing. The etiquettes, the morals and manners of these concepts. I need to be there. I need to be there. Today, subhanallah, you see the sheikh's name being advertised bigger than the topic. In fact, if there was no topic but just the sheikh's name, the venue will be full. You don't know, he might come to sell a car to you. Right? But that's fine. We came to see him. Why? Hey, you know, he's got a gift of the gab. You know, we get entertained. You know the jokes. Akhi, this sheikh, he can do stand-up comedy. It's entertainment. Astaghfirullah. We're not saying it's the blame of the sheikhs. We're saying the problem is how things are being perceived. Inshallah, the mashayikh and the students of knowledge don't intend this. They don't intend this. They're just trying to keep things current and keep you engaged. But sometimes things get lost in translation. People forget why they're coming here. Wallahi, you don't want to come and get sins and go back home thinking you got rewards, because you left home for the sake of other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because of the hype. There's a hype. I need to be there. I love this guy. Subhanallah. You know, very soon, who knows, you might go to a talk and see people with lighters and candles. Allahul Musta'an. You know, when a speaker comes in and some of the females are going out of breath. This is not intended. Wallahi, this is not. This ilm has an aura, has a haiba, has an honor far greater than any human being. Wallahi, understand this. And no speaker is what he is because of him. He is what he is because of what he says. You must remember this. You must remember this. It doesn't matter who you are, this body, this personality. It's what you say. We came here because you learned what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam left behind. We are fans of what you're going to say. We're not fans of you or your name or where you come from. We are fans of what you're going to say. We go out of breath for the knowledge of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. We're so desperate to hear it. This is where this is how it should be, brothers and sisters. Understand this. We're losing line of sight. May Allah protect us. Wallahi, a person will stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Qiyamah. And Allah will say, what did you do? Say, I studied. I learned the Quran. For you, ya Allah. Allah will say, kathabt. You are lying. You did it for other reasons. And the reasons you did it for, you enjoyed them. There's nothing for you here today. May Allah protect us. May Allah protect us. The speaker first. So brothers and sisters, understand this. You are followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not Sajid Umar. Not somebody else on the internet. No. And that's why we're going to discuss this. Giving due diligence and respect to your local scholars as well. Doesn't matter if they don't have a name. To say today we're so fixated on names by Allah. There are people who are unknown who have more knowledge than the people you know. But because you're so fixated on the name, you've shut your door to a plethora of ilm. A plethora of ilm. A plethora of ilm. And you know what? This is another thing we need to address. Subhanallah, our time has come to an end. But this is part of it. Let's address it. Let's take it all out. Let's take it all out and get it out there. You know, you need to be people who can be iman boosted yourself. And today, why is it that subhanallah, there's so many talks, but so less people who have an iman boost? They're only boosted at the time of the talk. They go home, second day, third day, back to square one. They need the sheikh to come back. And when he comes back, they run to him. like they're addicted to him, subhanallah. Why? It's not sustainable for organizations to keep paying airfares for people to come to Australia, the quote-unquote celebrities who you are fans of, to come and tell you to be iman boosted. Then you iman boosted, then they fly back. Ya akhi, it's a long travel, ya akhi. It's long, 14 hours, subhanallah, depending where you're flying from, right? It's not sustainable. It's like you telling me, you know what, every day come and charge my car battery. I'm saying, la hawla wa la quwwata. What do you think? Right? We got to be charged up ourselves. And you know what? I've thought about this, brothers and sisters. The way to be substantial is to learn ilm. Today, subhanallah, we only run to the talks that have the ha-ha-ha moments and have general nasiha. Somebody says, Melbourne, Medina, Kitabul Iman from Sahih al-Bukhari. Sheikh is coming to teach it. How many people will be here? No, Kitabul Iman, that name's boring. Even the name, subhanallah. Now on, you upload the talk, you have to think, what name now? You'll see, they'll tell you, Sheikh, what name can we put? Say, put the name, this is what I spoke about. No, it's not exciting enough, people won't watch this. Wallahi, this is what I get told. This is what I get told. They said, what's the name of this topic? I said, Fiqh Seerah. No, don't call it Fiqh Seerah. Don't call it Fiqh Seerah. By the way, I came up with the name. Blast from the past as well, alhamdulillah. I'm not saying it out of pride, it's a fact. Ask the brothers. Right? But the thing is, I first initially said Fiqh Seerah, they said no. It won't work. It won't work. Nobody will come. Fiqh Seerah? Boring. Because people only want to be attached to hype and trends. This is it. You cannot be iman boosted yourself this way. If you want to be iman boosted, learn solid knowledge. Learn solid knowledge. You know the talks that happen, general talks in masjid, this is nasiha. A 1 hour talk is nasiha. Someone's giving you advice. How many times do you want a person to tell you, be a good husband, be a good wife, be good with your in-laws, mother-in-law, don't fight with your daughter-in-law? How many times should we have these talks? Right? How many times should you be told, have khushu in your salah, have khushu in your salah, have khushu in your... How many times? And this is what we keep on coming back to listen to. It's the same message beaten out of a different box. But we come back for it. Why? Because this man came to say it. This is wrong. Ask yourself, why am I not substantial myself? Why am I not motivated myself? You know why? You don't have the tools of being motivated. You heard too much nasiha. You didn't learn ilm. You got to join between the two. You got to learn ilm and you got to yihad nasiha. You have to. If you learn the tools of motivation, you will be able to motivate yourself. Come to the tafsir lessons. Even if it's called tafsir. Come to the hadith lessons. They're also important, even if the sheikh is not known. I'm not saying you shouldn't find out who the sheikh is in terms of the background of his knowledge. No. But today, subhanallah, we must have such a big biography of the sheikh. What sports he likes, you know? Yeah, people relate to it. And I'm not saying it's wrong. We need to, you know, we need to do what we need to do because we're trying to infiltrate the youth. But at the end of the day, this ilm has a certain haiba which we need to respect. It has a certain haiba. How much can we peel off it so it appeases the masses? How much? Right? So my brothers and sisters, you hear? The hundreds of you, take it to 100 other people, please. Take it to them. That subhanallah, guys, you know what? We heard something that is food for thought. It's food for thought. You know, I did a Dhuhr reminder the other day. They said, what can we call it? I said, call it food for thought. The only food one's allowed to eat when you're fasting. Because it was a Dhuhr, they were fasting. This is food for thought that you can eat now because it's nighttime, alhamdulillah. Food for thought. Sometimes we enter a state of heedlessness. It's oblivion. It's oblivion. Right? Someone else could have come to this masjid to do this talk. I would expect you to be here. Expect you to come and learn. He's a graduate from a place. He's got ilm. He's been taught by knowledgeable people. He's got ilm. I am in love with the inheritance of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I will go to wherever it comes from. That's what it is. You're not in love with Sheikh so and so, and student of knowledge so and so, and propagator so and so. I'm in love with the inheritance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is what is my, that's what drives me. That's what makes me leave my home. I love him so much. I want to know everything about him. And I have an opportunity to learn about him. So let me go. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the understanding. Now, brothers and sisters, to qualify, before we close, I'm not saying everyone needs to now run to Medina. Well, this Melbourne, Medina, come, you're welcome. But I'm talking about Medina, the Islamic University of Medina. Right? Many a time we feel that to do something good for Islam, we need to go study Islam deeply. I'm not saying everyone needs to go there. The Ummah needs doctors, it needs lawyers, it needs everybody. The Ummah needs it. Go do that. But what I'm saying is, learn what you have to learn. Remember the other day I said knowledge is of two types. Knowledge which is fardhu ayn. It's compulsory upon every human being. Every human being to know. Not just the scholars. And then there's knowledge which is considered fardh kifaya. Fardh kifaya is a communal obligation. If the scholars learn it, it's enough. There's knowledge, or the knowledge I'm speaking about is that which you have to know, brothers and sisters. The other day we discussed saying touch wood, fingers crossed. This is something you should know, you have to know. You have to know. You're sinful for not knowing and you're sinful for not practicing. Where are you going to learn? At the feet of the scholars. And alhamdulillah, Allah has sent you scholars to your community. You don't have to go to Medina to learn this. You don't have to invest 7 years. You can go become an engineer. But be a well-grounded, founded, sounded engineer. Be the engineer who is the best. We spoke about being the best. The one who the whole world wants to learn from. And whilst they're learning from him, he hears the adhan from outside of his company. Multi-billion dollar corporation that hires thousands of people. He hears the adhan across the street from a masjid which he built. Allahu Akbar. And then he goes there to be the imam and lead the prayer. And after that, share a reminder and inspire the ummah. Can you not be that? Of course you can be that. You're supposed to invite to what you know. And you can be an engineer as well. And a doctor as well. The ummah needs this. The ummah needs doctors who are the best. Engineers who are the best. Policy makers who are the best. The ummah needs this. Right? You don't have to all become sheikhs and muftis and people who pass fatwa. But what you have to do in your endeavor to be the best professional is learn everything the Sharia made compulsory upon you to learn. You as an individual. Understand this. And that is why Allah said, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Ask the people of knowledge if you don't know. Because you have the people of knowledge who know what you don't need to know. And if you need to know, you can ask them. That's what it means. But you as a Muslim need to know what you have to know. 5 times salah, how to perform salah, what breaks my salah, trade. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu an would test people before they went into the market. Test them. Fiqh of finance. One-on-one. Right? Test them. Let's see, what's the ruling here? What's the ruling there? You don't know? Not pass, you can't go trade. Why? You're going to trade, you have to know matters pertaining to trade. It's compulsory for you to know this. You can't say it's the scholar's job and you're just going to wing it. Right? As we say today, just wing it. You can't wing it. This is deen. This is Jannah and Jahannam, ya akhi. This is your Islam, my dear brother and sister. Right? And from this discussion, learn how important our scholars are. Because as I said, there's certain knowledge which is farad kifaya. That which is a communal obligation. Which means, if someone from our community went to learn, the obligation is lifted. So when you see someone studying Islam, you should kiss their feet. I'm not saying literally, but I'm saying understand who they are. They have lifted a burden off your shoulders. Had they not gone, you would be sinful. Everyone would be sinful. But because they went, the farad has been lifted. They've lifted a mighty load off the community. Have we ever thought about this? No. That's why we disrespect our scholars. We don't know what they've done for us. Wallahi, the moment the student is at the airport, he's going to study Islam, you should thank him from the bottom of your heart. He's done something that has lifted a great obligation off your shoulder. And when he comes back, support him or her, if she's a female student of knowledge. Alhamdulillah alladhi ja'ala fi kulli fatratin min ar-rusuli baqaya min ahli al-ilm yad'una man dhalla ila al-huda wa yasbiruna minhum 'ala al-adha. يحيون بكتاب الله تعالى الموتى ويبصرون بنور الله أهل العمى فكم من قتيل لإبليس قد أحيوا وكم من ضال قد هدوا فَمَا أَحْسَنَ أَثَرُهُمْ عَلَى النَّاسِ وَمَا أَقْبَحْ أَثَرُ النَّاسِ عَلَيْهِمْ. A wise man said, praises belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who inspired the presence of scholars during every portion of time. After every prophet left, Allah left behind scholars after them. يَدْعُونَ مَنْ ضَلَّ إِلَى الْهُدَى. They invite the misguided people towards guidance. وَيَصْبِرُونَ مِنْهُمْ عَلَى الْأَذَى. And they are patient upon the harm that the people give them. Wallahi, communities, they give you trouble when you try and invite them towards good. Look what Waraqa told Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They're going to have it in for you. They're going to drive you out. يَصْبِرُونَ مِنْهُمْ عَلَى الْأَذَى. They're patient. The scholars are patient with the harm the people give them. The fact that they haven't realized that we have helped them. The scholars have helped them. The students of knowledge have helped them. They've lifted an obligation off them. So they're patient with the harm. يُحْيَوْنَ بِكِتَابِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى الْمَوْتَى. They give life, spiritual life, with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to those who are spiritually dead. وَيُبَصِّرُونَ بِنُورِ اللَّهِ أَهْلَ الْعَمَى. And they give spiritual eyesight to those who are spiritually blind. فَكَمْ مِنْ قَتِيلٍ لِإِبْلِيسٍ قَدْ أَحْيَوْا. How many people has Iblis caused to become spiritually dead, have they made spiritually alive and revived? وَكَمْ مِنْ ضَالٍ قَدْ هَدَوْا. And how many misguided people has Allah guided upon the hands of the scholars? He says, how amazing has the benefit of the scholar been upon the people, and how evil has the harm of the people been upon the scholar. I end with this point today, my dear brothers and sisters. We have much to discuss tomorrow. Subhanallah, we're right on the first point, the first benefit. Allahu Akbar. But I told you, the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is nothing but substantial. You know, I was hoping to finish with you the Makkan period. Allah knows best if I will. I might need 3 trips to Australia. Everything correct said is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He's perfect, and all praises belong to Allah for blessing my voice and making it last. I pray that He does so, so that we can pray the Qiyam as well together. Any mistakes are from myself and Shaytan, and I seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's forgiveness. May Allah increase our knowledge. May Allah forgive our mistakes. May Allah make us people of tawheed and sincerity. Ameen. May Allah grant us Laylatul Qadr and accept our Ramadan and gather us in Jannah in the same way He has gathered us here today. Ameen. هذا والله أعلم وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحان الله وبحمده. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك. نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت. نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.